ChatGPT's function calling is not just a feature, it's a revolution for language model developers. Now, some might argue that this functionality is nothing unique, claiming that it's essentially the LangChain tools neatly wrapped in an OpenAI package. But speaking from experience as a developer who successfully integrated numerous databases with ChatGPT, I can assure you that the picture is drastically different. In fact, there's almost nothing similar in between how LangChain tools and ChatGPT function calling work under the hood. So today, I'll pull back the curtain on this game-changing feature and take you on a guided tour of a real-world SQL database integration so you can find ways to leverage this unique opportunity in your own applications. Let's get started. With function calling, you can now pass multiple function definitions to ChatGPT, empowering the model to decide when and how to use them in its responses. When needed, ChatGPT will output a special message with the corresponding function and its necessary parameters based on your function descriptions. Now, if you've worked with LangChain tools, the way we define these functions may already seem very familiar to you. However, don't jump into conclusions just yet, as function definitions may be the only similarity between them. The difference lies in the fact that these newer OpenAI models have been specifically trained to call functions, while their predecessors had no idea what to do with them initially. As of now, there are no other open source or commercially available models that had function definitions integrated directly into their training data. This is why you often see these large and confusing prompts in LangChain that leave smaller models confused. These models simply don't know that they can use tools initially, whereas function calling models are already aware of this fact. So there is no need to explain to function calling models that they must generate some code to call a function. They already know they can output a function message when required because they were fine-tuned this way. Not only does this save your tokens, but it also boosts the overall accuracy of the process, which is a gift for developers like us. And the possibilities here are immense. Some use cases that I can think of right now include advanced chatbots with database integrations, data analysis applications, educational platforms, research assistants, booking services, smart home automation, and much more. However, keep in mind that this method has its own limitations, which I'll discuss later in the video. But for now, let's dive into a practical example of how to utilize this cutting-edge feature to connect to a SQL database. In this tutorial, I'll guide you through a notebook I've created that compares a SQL database chain implementation using LangChain with one that leverages function calling. Make sure to stay until the end for some comparison and testing. In this notebook, we'll use the Chinook database, a sample music store database which you can download using the following commands. Next, set up the connection to your database and set your OpenAI API key. Remember that only June 13 models currently support function calling, so ensure you specify the version accordingly in your own applications. To create the database schema, we need only three functions, one to get the table names, another to get the columns for each table, and a third to combine them. We'll then join these into a string and use it in the function description when calling OpenAI. Now, we can proceed with the function definition. When passing a function to OpenAI, it must contain attributes for name, description, and parameters. In a parameter attributes specify the properties and their types that your function will use. In our case, we will need only one function called AskDatabase with one property called query as a string. We will insert our schema into the description of the property and make it required. Feel free to add more tools for your own application here. Next, let's define the AskDatabase function itself. All it has to do is parse the query that ChatGPT returns, execute it, and then return the results. Now comes the interesting part. In our next function, we will call the OpenAI chat completion endpoint in a loop with our new function until ChatGPT returns the desired response. This code allows us to execute multiple ChatGPT function calls if necessary. This is basically all it takes to recreate the SQL database chain from LangChain. But not only that, the chain is also more error-prone, as I will demonstrate soon. To make the comparison, we also just need to connect LangChain to our SQL database and initialize the chain. Now we're finally ready to test. First, let's run a simple query to identify the most popular genre among customers based on the number of tracks sold in that genre. Both implementations provided fairly similar responses. Next, let's try something more challenging. The task is to find the customer who has spent the most in each genre and display their total spending for each genre. This requires a more complex query, so let's see the results. Although the LangChain implementation was able to construct the query, the response is unclear. Instead of providing its interpretation, the model states that the results are displayed in a SQL query, which the end user should not see. This is the exact problem we discussed earlier. Since LangChain passes a lot of information through the user message, the model assumes that the user is aware of this information, leading to confusion for both the user and the model. Meanwhile, the OpenAI function calling implementation easily constructs the query and lists the results for us accordingly. Finally, for the hardest question, identify the artist with the highest revenue excluding compilations and display their top selling track, LangChain was unable to construct the query correctly. While the function calling implementation not only constructed the query, but also outputted the results in a neat table format. Function calling represents a significant step forward in natural language processing. processing because it enables the creation of reliable natural language APIs in seconds. Basically, any function that has some form of documentation can now be accessed by ChatGPT. Not only that, but it also significantly improves the accuracy with function calls, which is one of the biggest issues for any complex integrations. However, as I mentioned earlier, there is one major drawback compared to many agent implementations. Function calling does not allow for asynchronous execution. This means that each function OpenAI returns must be executed sequentially rather than all at once like with Baby AGI or AutoGPT. This increases the latency, but I still believe that the performance gains outweigh the weight. I'm excited to see what you all come up with for this feature. If you have any ideas, please feel free to share them in the comments. I'd be more than happy to chat with you and hear your thoughts. And if you want to know more about how to leverage the power of AI, don't forget to subscribe.